came back from my June holiday with my two young kids, 9 and 11, Dent, from Melbourne. I still remember very vividly. I had a kind of a breast lump on my left breast. But things just happened so fast that you just got no time to think about it. And the next thing, your breast is gone. Into my sixth year, when there was a DNA test about this called BRCA1, similar to what Angelina Jolie has. I always tell my survivors, before Angelina Jolie told the whole white world that she has lost her two breasts, I've done mine already and lost everything to that already. Everything was very smooth until a month later, when my husband was hit with a rare cancer. I think that was the worst time in my life that I have to go through. And it's been 1.5 years already, and we fight it well, and we overcome that. Seeing through mom going through one surgery, seeing through dad another surgery, it was quite hard on my two kids, you know. But we become a very strong, unique family. We wouldn't be defeated by the big C, you know. United we stand. I have major milestones ever since I was struck with cancer. I wrote down a list of things that I want to do. And one of them is to hit the Mount Everest base camp, which I did 1 year after my chemo. And that was the first take together with my husband. We are not really trained, but I think it's mind over body. I hit the two mountains. I did my marathon. I did my triathlon. And so what's next? My passion is actually dragon boating, called BCF Paddlers in the Pink, which is a dragon boat team for all breast cancer survivors and supporters who come together. I call it a floating support. You see the ladies who conquered their chemo and surgery, they become so strong now. If I can say, oh, this lady is 60 years old and still paddling, if she can do it, I can do it as well. And so that's the message, and that's my passion, to share the joy that you can lead an active lifestyle after cancer. One lifetime, dare it.